A number of people, when asked where the shots came from, said there was no way to tell. There's too much reverberation.
The Kennedy assassination is just one example of the difficulty of pinpointing gunshots. Locating where shots are coming from is hard for anyone, even trained soldiers, especially in urban environments.
It's a major problem for our soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan to be able to understand where shooters are in these urban environments. Multiple buildings, multiple locations that the shockwaves reverberate off of and give us multiple sound signatures.
At New Mexico Tech, Professor Michael Hargather studies shockwaves caused by explosions. Using a special high-speed camera, extremely bright focused light, and a reflective screen, his team takes pictures of sound.
We can literally photograph the invisible, small density differences within the air. What we're going to see here with the shattergraph system is we're going to see a line that is the shadow cast by that shockwave.
Down.
That line represents the interface between the unshocked ambient air and then what we call the shocked air behind that shockwave.
John, you ready?
Ready.
Camera's ready.
Photographing a high-speed rifle bullet reveals two different shockwaves. One, V-shaped, is created by the bullet traveling faster than the speed of sound. The other by the gases that propel it.
There's really multiple pieces to this event. The bullet, we can talk about it being supersonic as it exits the gun because it's traveling faster than the speed of sound. And the burning of the gunpowder, that produces what we call a muzzle blast.
So with a supersonic rifle bullet like the Carcano, an observer can hear two sounds, the crack of the bullet passing, followed by the blast of the gun that fired it, like so, all bouncing and echoing between the buildings in Dealey Plaza.
In a complicated geometry like Dealey Plaza in Dallas, you could get multiple shock reflections in that geometry. And so someone could hear multiple sounds from a single shot. But